Ian Moss is one of Australia's best known and best loved musicians. He was a founding member of Cold Chisel after he answered an ad for a guitarist in a shop window in 1973. I wish we could get a shot of Bradley right now drumming, but he's also had a successful solo career, winning 5 ARIA Awards in 1 year for his single Tucker's Daughter and album Matchbook. Since Chisel reformed, he now juggles both, and he is our first music guest on New Late News. Welcome, Ian Moss. We're really excited to have you here. Thanks very much for coming in.
My pleasure.
You've been the thing we've been looking forward to all week. Just looking through your schedule in researching this interview, you must be one of the busiest people around. Your tour dates are just incredible.
Yeah, they're on and off. I was very busy last year with the Cold Chisel. Like the Nitro Tour, where we did 36 dates in about 60 days or something.
That's wow. What keeps you wanting to tour like that, to just keep going and going and going? What keeps you wanting to do it?
Just love playing.
I
can speak on behalf of all Cold Chisel members. It's, there may be some differences we've had over the years, but one thing that's always remained consistent invariably is that whenever we do get on the stage and start playing, all hassles go out the window, and there's just a real pleasure, a joy.
Can I just say, I can't call you Ian, you'll always be Mossy, Mossy and Barnsey, mate, from Chisel. 40 years ago you started in pubs, here you are, you're playing to thousands in arenas. How has Chisel managed to stay so relevant after all these years?
Good. I don't know. We're stoked with the way it went last year, and quite frankly, when management said, okay, we're booking a few venues, we'll get this tour underway, we've got the entertainment centre, Ace Arena, etc. Everyone's like, what are you doing? We're going to look pretty silly with these things, are only quarter full. But they, of course, it went completely the other way, and we're surprised, just as surprised, really, as anyone else. But I guess it's got to come down to, a lot of it comes down to, I always take the hat off to Don Walker mainly, because he did write the bulk of the songs, and he wrote songs that were meant to last, melodically. He wrote songs that were for people, about people, about real issues.
Ian, I've got to ask you, how's your hand going? Because I believe that you were a victim of the family cat. This is quite a bad attack.
Wow. Sorry,
that's
the finger.
Wow.
So what happened? It must have been so bad you had to cancel a show. Yes.
Is that really the cat's eyes?
His
green eyes?
Yeah, that's not just a flash.
No wonder it attacked you.
He's always like that.
What did it do to you?
Well, there I was. I'm trying to give the bad cat its medicine. But no, because it's a big, strong lad, but he's 16. He's thyroid gland problems. So trying to give him medication, trying to get a pill down his throat, and it sort of didn't quite. And he sunk the tooth in big time, and it ging hurt. I knew I was in trouble.
You're playing Bow River for us tonight. Just tell us what it means. I mean, a lot of people have their own interpretation of that song.
Bow River was really just a... I wrote that back in the early days in Sydney. I come from Alice Springs. I've lived in Sydney for more than half of my life, but still part of me still yearns and still loves the open spaces and the hot red, dry areas up way up in the deep north. And that's the song was written at a time... it was early days in Sydney, and we were doing it pretty tough, and every now and then you get homesick and just want to go home, and that's essentially what it's all about.
Right. We've got to go to the break, unfortunately. I know we've all got more questions we want to ask you. You've got a bunch of tour dates coming up across Australia, also some further on the track, but we've got all the details on our Facebook page, so people can go there and tap into those. Still to come, though, tomorrow's weather, the links you should be looking at tonight, and Ian Moss, we should say thank you, actually, before we go to the break. Thank you for coming in, and you're going to play Bow River for us in a few minutes' time.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mossy.
All right, stay with us here on The Late News.